Hi students, in this session we are going to discuss about unit banking. This is the second unit, okay? Unit 2. Banking systems. Okay, in banking systems, first one is unit banking. So first of all, what is unit banking? Unit banking is a one of the single bank. It is a one of the single bank operated with only one single branch office. There is no two or more branches in anywhere. Okay, there is no two or more branches in anywhere. So it is a single branch. It is originated in USA. In USA, okay. So first of all, it is only for local geographical purpose. Okay. So in unit banking, there is a four points of important for meaning. So unit banking is operates in a specified area, generally small and limited area. Small and limited area operates small and okay limited area. So unit banking, first point meaning. Okay, then second point, it perform activities through a single office within limited resources, having no branches. So in unit banking, there is no branches, unit banking having no branches. So it is worked, so it is performed activities through a single office within a limited resources. It means capital is very low and it is a small office. Okay, small office. Then third one, it is localized bank. It is localized only for local activities. Okay, then originated in USA. So it is worked in USA, United States of America. So these are the four points of meaning of unit banking. So it is a important question for 10 marks category in unit 2. Okay, so many times asking in semester examination. That's why listen carefully. You have in your, keep in your mind these four points, then you will write each and every merit and demerit also. Every merits and demerits also easily write. Okay, so first one is, it is a single office, there is no branches. Okay, then it is a small, okay, specified area, it operates specified area, small and limited area. Next, then third one, it is a localized bank and originated in USA. Someone defined unit banking, Solomon and White. According to Solomon and White, an independent unit bank is an independent, because of it is a single branch, that's why it is independent. Independent unit bank is a corporation that operates one office, that operates one office and that is not related to other banks through either ownership or control. Either ownership or control, not related other banks. It means no having any branches. So that is defined by the Solomon and White. So this is the definition. So we are now, we are going to discuss about merits of unit banking. So merits and demerits. Okay, 10 points of merits and 10 points of demerits. So first one, merit. First one in merits, merits are advantages. Okay, merits are advantages. Okay, so first one is effective management. It is management. Okay, effective management. So unit banking system is a working as a effective management in local area only because of it having only one branch. Unit banking having only one branch, that's why it is worked effective management. Effective management in the one office, that's why it is the one of advantages of unit banking system. Then second point, based on local needs. So unit banking started a bank depending upon or based on local needs. So any local area wanted to need the bank system, that time start the unit banking. Okay, so it is based on local needs. So it is worked in small and limited area, that's why it is also one of the advantage point. Then third point, elimination of inefficient banks. It means some like commercial banks are so many branches, having so many branches in India. Okay, that's why so there in commercial banks are inefficient because of so many employees are worked. That's talented person or non-talented persons also work in the commercial banks. That's why sometimes we are having inefficient. But in unit banking system, it is only used for local area. That's why it's eliminated. Unit banking eliminated inefficient banks. Then check on monopolies. It means unit banking system is a single bank, so it is a one of the monopoly means single. So it is the one of the single banking system, that's why it decided each and every transaction, it defined each and every transaction in the unit banking system. Okay, then no delay. Because of in unit banking system there is no delays, because unit banking is a local bank. Any person want to transaction for deposit or withdraw, whatever it is only easily reached the office. It is limited area. Okay, within the limited area, that's why no delay of operations or transactions in unit banking system. So this is also one of the important merit or advantages of unit banking system. Then no danger economy, because of it is advantage to economy. Why? Because so it is it is based on local needs. It means rural area also started a unit banking system. That's why rural areas are developed through unit banking system. That's why unit banking are increased economy, small number of economy. So there is no danger to economy. Okay, in case of it is loss, it is going to loss, there is no economy danger, and it is profit, there is no economy danger. Okay, balanced growth, it is balanced growth because of having few staff. Why? Because it means say one office only few staff, so small number of workers are worked in the bank, and then also reduce the cost of each and every transaction. So reduce the cost and low workers are worked in the single office, that is called unit banking system. So this is also one of the important key. Then utility for local development. Why? Because unit banking system is a based on only for local needs. That's why it is developed local areas. So it is also one of the advantage point in unit banking system. Okay, then fewer chance of frauds. So in unit banking system, the frauds are is very very low, some 1% or 0.5% maximum 0.5% of frauds there in unit banking system, or 1% compared with commercial banks. So commercial banks, so many frauds are there, but in unit banking system fewer chance of frauds. Why? Because unit banking system is a single office, that's why any person want to fraud of bank that time, so it is easily find out frauds by management. Okay, this is also one of the important area. Then and last one, handling the local problems. Because of unit banking already know about each and every problem about the local needs, that's why unit banking system handling the local each and every problem for the unit banking system. So students, these are the merits of unit banking system. It is very easy points and very very easy question. Okay, so you can listen again, so I can repeat the points. First one is effective management, then based on local needs, eliminate of inefficient banks, check on monopoly, no delay of operations, no danger to economy, balanced growth, utility for local development, fewer chance of frauds in unit banking system, handling the local problems because of it is a depending up based on local, it is started based on local needs. So students, these are the merits of unit banking system. Is it clear? Then next topic, disadvantages of unit banking system. Lack of specialization in unit banking system, the employees are lack of specialization. Okay, because of it is a single bank system, that's why it is no specialization. Okay, then second one, higher remittance cost higher remittance cost. So it is a only single branch, it is only single branch, that's why maintenance cost of employees maintenance, then organization each and every expenditure can taken from the customer of banks. Okay, that's why it is increase the remittance cost. Okay, so it is also one of the disadvantages of unit banking system. Then third one, no possibility of geographically distributed risk. So in unit banking system, compulsory no possibility, 100% no possibility of geographically distributed risk. Why? Because it is only based on local needs, only having one branch. That's why no possibility of geographically distributed risk. Then fourth point, lack of banking facility in small towns. So it is maximum operated only cities and towns. So it is lack of banking facility in small towns. Small towns means rural areas. So that's why because no banking facility in rural areas, because of rural areas are not paid any higher cost compared with cities. That's why rural areas or small towns lack of banking facilities in rural areas. This is also one of the demerit. Okay, demerit or disadvantages. Okay, then fifth one, difficult in facing economic problems. Because of in unit banking system, there is low customers are there. That's why, so it is having main problem of economic problems. So salaries given to employees or maintenance cost of rent, electricity, other maintenance charges is very difficult or facing economic problems. Economic means money. Okay, next, lack of trained staff. Because of it is a single office, so that's why there is no taking any training and development programs by management. So that's why unit banking employees are lack of trained staffs. There is no training of staffs. Then limited resources. This point we already discussed in the meaning. Okay, limited resources, it means lowest capital, lowest profit. In case you are giving best capital, you will earn best profits. That's why in unit banking system, you are giving limited resources as a capital. That's why limited resources are one of the disadvantages. It is a very lower profits. Okay, sometimes it will go into loss period also. Okay, then expensive transfer of funds. In case it is transfer of funds our branch to any other branch customer, not our branch, any other bank customer, it is more expensive because of we are having only one branch in local area. Okay, Then ninth point, different interest rate in case of there is having any economic problems, that time interest rate will increased by unit banking system. So that way different interest rate, there is no common, there is no exact interest rates. Depending upon economic problems, interest rate will be changed by unit banks. Okay, then local pressure. So in unit banking system, there is many local pressures are there. So this type of pressures are facing with unit banking systems. So these are the disadvantages of unit banking. So students, I will repeat the points. So listen carefully. First one, lack of specialization. It means all staff are, there is no specialized person. That's why not best performed on the job. Then higher remittance cost. Higher remittance cost. So it is very costly for each and every transaction for facing the economic problems. Then third one, no possibility of geographically distributed risk. Okay, then fourth one, lack of banking facility in small towns or rural areas. So lack of banking system. So unit banking is not started in rural areas. Difficult in facing economic problems. So it is very, very, very difficult in economic problems. So lack of trained staff. There is no trained staffs are there in unit banks. Limited resources. So in unit banking system, limited resources are there. That's why so banks are earn lower profit, and also sometime it will go into loss period. Okay, that's why closed off unit banking also maybe. Okay, then expensive transfer of funds. So it is transfer to our branch to any other bank branch, other bank branch transfer, it is very expensive. And different interest rates, it is interest rate depending upon the economic problems. In case they are facing many more economic problems, that time interest rate will be increased. In case there is no small economic problems, that time interest rate will be decreased. So it is depending upon the unit bank economic problems. Then local pressure. So unit banks are based on local needs, that's why it is facing with local pressures. So students, this is the unit banking system. And next topic is
most popular and important commercial. cash banking, the two topics are very important in semester category, Tenmos category. Okay, then definition by Goldfield and Chandler. Goldfield and CHANDLER. Okay, so Goldfield and Chandler, different branch banking. resume